and two or three of the older people, I was even not knowing it. I used to take something up to them and I was practically giving them all the food they were getting. And I just suddenly thought, this can't go on. And I had the men for tea, and after I'd fed them to, they were boiling over, or bursting over, I wrote the subject of evacuation. And the oldest one, Finn McGillis, got up, and with tears streaming down his face, he put his arm round me. He said, I think you've a good idea what's happening. He said, we just have mostly got that we haven't even a penny for the food. He said, there's nothing here to earn. And when the visitors come to buy the tweed, he says, all the tweed we can make couldn't possibly keep us. And he said, you practically feed the children. You give them something to eat every day. And I said, well, would you consider leaving the island? And the whole lot of them were up a shot. Yes, but we can't afford to do that. How can we do it?
I really felt it was rather sad to think that a whole community should be just moved off the island. Because I know we were a poor people, and I think a little help from the government or from some source would have helped them along. I mean, living was very hard on the island right now. We depended upon the few sheep we had and the tweed we made. And a little money here and there would have helped the island a great lot. And I think people would have been quite happy to be left alone as a community the way we live. Because we didn't know anything else. And that was our whole world.
They asked the government to evacuate them. And my father felt that that was a thing he should thoroughly approve of and accept, but that he would not take any active part in it because he knew that there was so much prejudice in some circles against the Lairds that he was afraid that people might say that the Laird was anxious to evacuate the people from his land. So though he cooperated, it was in an entirely negative way.
Oh, it was just the same as any other day. We didn't bother much about it. See, everybody went to church, I think a day or two before we left. Well, everybody left at the same time. So
I think what they found most unusual when they came to Morven was a motor car. Instead of stepping aside, as we do, of course, and as everyone else in this, the mainland does, the St Kilda simply ran ahead as fast as it could. The one thing that I was afraid of was that they wouldn't have the same resistance to disease as what we had. We developed a resistance to things like tuberculosis. I was afraid we'd have an outbreak of tuberculosis. Well, it did hit one family. There were at least five out of that family of eight who all died of TB.
On the mainland, tuberculosis continued to take its toll. John MacDonald died of it. Norman MacKinnon contracted it and could never work again. And another islander, Donald Gillis, had to have a lung removed.